What's up? Merde here. And in this video, we're going to go through the fascia you'll find in the abdomen. So the fascia of the abdomen covers the muscles of the abdomen from both the external and the internal side. So here I've cut through all the muscle layers of the abdomen. And remember, they consist of the external oblique, internal oblique, and the transverse abdominal muscle. These three are considered the lateral abdominal muscles. And we have the anterior abdominal muscles, like the rectus abdominis. Our goal in this video is to go through the fascia that you will find wrapping around these muscles and separating them from the organs within the abdominal cavity. So in this video, we're going to go through the superficial fascia, we will go through the investing abdominal fascia, and we will go through the endoabdominal fascia. And to do that, we will have to make a transverse cut of the abdomen, remove the upper half, and look at it from this perspective. And now, we're going to try to draw all the structures and go through them as we do that. First, we have the skin, and right underneath the skin layers, we will find the adipose tissue, or fat cells. Underneath the fat cells, we can find the external oblique, internal oblique, and the transverse abdominal muscle. And in the middle here, we can see the rectus abdominis muscle. So this is a very schematic outline of the abdominal muscles. The first fascia we're going to go through is associated with the fat layer. The fascia that covers the fat layer from the superficial side is called the fascia of Camper. And the fascia that cover it from the inner side is called the fascia of Scarpa. These two layers of fascia together form the so-called superficial fascia. So that is the first one in our list. Next, we have a fascia called the investing abdominal fascia. And as the name implies, this fascia is going to surround the abdominal muscles. So the investing abdominal fascia is divided into three layers. First is the superficial investing abdominal fascia surrounding the external oblique. Then there's the intermediate investing abdominal fascia surrounding the internal oblique. Then there's the deep investing abdominal fascia surrounding the transverse abdominal muscle. Now, underneath the deep investing abdominal fascia, that's where you will find the third fascia we're going to talk about, called the endoabdominal fascia. And just underneath the endoabdominal fascia, that's where you'll find the parietal peritoneum, which covers all the organs from the inner surface of the abdominal cavity. Now, the endoabdominal fascia is actually divided into certain parts depending on the location of it. So let's look at that by drawing the lateral view of the abdomen. First, we have the skin, then the fat cells, then the external oblique, internal oblique, and the transverse abdominis. Deeper to those muscles, we will find the endoabdominal fascia. And here, just to orientate, we will add a perfectly drawn diaphragm and the quadratus lumborum muscle. Now, the endoabdominal fascia gets different names depending on its location. If we're looking at the endoabdominal fascia from the abdominal part, it's going to get the name the transversalis fascia. If the endoabdominal fascia is in the pelvis, it's called the iliac fascia. And it has some other names as well depending on the region, but the transversalis fascia and the iliac fascia are the most important ones to know when you're studying the fascia of the abdomen. And again, just underneath the endoabdominal fascia is the parietal peritoneum. And that, my friends, are the three fascias that I wanted to talk about in this video.